There's been a surge of interest in using psychedelics to treat psychiatric disorders, especially as new drugs get close to being approved by the Food and Drug Administration. I've recently talked about two of them that are the closest to coming to market, which are MDMA, street name ecstasy, and psilocybin, which comes from mushrooms. Both of these drugs break away from the standard approach to treating depression that we've used for many years, which is boosting neurotransmitter levels like serotonin, norepinephrine, and dopamine. But as we've advanced our understanding of how the brain works, we've discovered other pathways towards fixing the problem at the nerve wiring level and not just increasing brain chemicals. Like a lot of people, I'm holding my breath waiting for psilocybin. I think it will be the game changer for how we treat depression and other disorders. But in the meantime, what about ketamine, known on the street as Special K? Why hasn't it gotten as much attention as the other psychedelics when it's already available? Probably because the FDA-approved pharmaceutical version, Spravato, doesn't work quite the same way as ketamine infusion works. So let me reacquaint you with ketamine and where it fits with the other psychedelics. Ketamine became commercially available in 1970 as an anesthetic drug. It's a derivative of phencyclidine, PCP, known on the street as angel dust. Ketamine turned out to be a better option than PCP because it caused less agitation and psychosis. It provides very good pain control, a dissociative state, and amnesia for the event, which means you won't remember what happened during the procedure while you were under, and you won't feel pain from what had been done to you. That's exactly what you want when you're having a procedure. Technically speaking, ketamine is not considered a classic psychedelic like psilocybin and LSD. Those agents are classified that way because of their hallucinogenic properties, and they work on the serotonin receptors in the brain. Also, the Greek origin of the word psychedelic means mind manifesting. Therefore, psychedelics are considered drugs that open your mind to new ways of thinking and viewing the world. Ketamine doesn't quite do that, but it gets lumped in with the psychedelics because of the dissociative effects and the way it works on your brain's nerve connections. Dissociation is an experience where you become disconnected from your environment or yourself. You can have what feels like an out-of-body experience. This out-of-body feeling, or feeling like your environment is changing, is not the same as experiencing a hallucination, which is what happens with the psychedelics, or what can happen with the psychedelics. But those are nitpicky details that I'm glossing over to get to the good part, which is how ketamine really works to improve your mental functioning. Ketamine increases the protein BDNF, which stands for brain-derived neurotrophic factor. I've talked about BDNF before in my discussion of magnesium for anxiety, intermittent fasting, and exercise. In contrast to intermittent fasting and exercise, ketamine has a robust effect on BDNF, which means it helps break the loose problematic nerve connections and helps grow newer, stronger connections. And as such, ketamine works very fast. It's the most powerful, fastest agent to take away suicidal thoughts. The next two in line for doing that are lithium and ECT, but neither of those work as fast as intravenous ketamine. Ketamine treatment is available in five forms: intravenous, intramuscular, intranasal, sublingual, which goes under your tongue, and oral capsules. The most potent form is intravenous. The medication goes straight into your bloodstream. Intranasal ketamine, where you sniff it, is only about 45% bioavailable, which means your brain gets less than half the dose that you ingested. Oral ketamine is only 17 to 23% available, which means it doesn't work nearly as fast as the infusions. So IV ketamine is really in its own class of treatment and steps ahead of the oral form. But a downside is it requires a lot of monitoring, and the better ketamine centers have someone who has had anesthesia training administering the infusions. The usual treatment cycle is between 6 and 10 treatments conducted 2 to 3 times a week over 2 to 3 weeks. That's considered an induction treatment or loading dose. Many people have reported improvement after just one or two sessions, but to get the full benefit of the treatment and have the results last longer, you should complete the full course of at least 6 treatments. The infusions last about 40 minutes, and a medical team monitors your vitals before, during, and after the infusion. Then what happens? Some people remain without depression symptoms for months, but some have a relapse of symptoms before that. To address this issue, some people will get maintenance booster doses of 1 to 2 infusions on a monthly basis. Some people will return to taking their antidepressants, but they notice that they respond better to the antidepressant or need less medication overall after receiving ketamine. Some people will get maintenance intranasal ketamine that they take home. Now, ketamine is not without side effects. The common ones are dizziness, nausea, and persistent dissociative symptoms, like randomly feeling like you're floating. But in general, it's considered to be better tolerated than the antidepressants. So why wouldn't everyone just get this? Well, one reason is that it tends to be reserved for more severe cases of depression or for people who haven't gotten enough help with traditional antidepressants. But probably the biggest reason that it's not for everyone is cost. I've mentioned using it for depression, but some centers like Mindpeace Clinics, which is located in Virginia and California, are also using it for anxiety, OCD, certain pain syndromes, and PTSD. None of these disorders are included in the FDA approval for ketamine, so the treatment is off-label. As such, most insurances won't cover the cost. The average cost per session is $400 to $800. If you get 6 sessions, you're talking $2,400 to $4,800 for your initial treatment. That's not cheap by any means. But I will say, if you had to beg or borrow for some kind of treatment, this is one where you should know very soon if it's going to help you or not before you spend too much money. To put things in perspective, some seasoned therapists charge $400 an hour for a therapy session. But seeing changes in therapy takes time. Even with the best person, 6 sessions of therapy is not going to take you from urinating on yourself because you can't get out of bed and packing a gun in your nightstand to standing in line to see a movie all in 6 sessions. What about the FDA-approved medication Spravato? Spravato is not quite the same as ketamine. It's S-ketamine, a derivative product of ketamine. It works similarly to ketamine, but it is delivered intranasally, so it doesn't quite pack the same punch as getting ketamine delivered directly into your bloodstream. Spravato is also expensive and not all insurances cover it. But if yours does, it may be worth a try. One more option that I'm not necessarily recommending but want to make you aware of, and that is getting oral ketamine from an online clinic. There are some places that will do an online evaluation and then ship you oral ketamine, not Spravato, in a box for you to take at home. With Spravato, because of the dissociative feature of the drug, you have to spend a couple of hours in the doctor's office taking the medication under supervision and then being monitored afterwards. It's even recommended that you have a driver take you home. So with this home delivery situation, you get the oral medication delivered to you and you have access via Zoom, text, or an app to have virtual monitoring and support. One such facility is MindBloom. The caveat here is you can only use them if they have someone on staff who's licensed in your state. I couldn't find a list of states that they serve, but instead I had to go through the screening process and give them my email address, only to find out at the very end that they don't serve Georgia. But if they did, the cost for a new client is $89 a week for 6 treatments, but you're billed for 3 months. So the total cost of this treatment is $1,068, which is less than half the cost of the IV ketamine for 6 treatments. This is more affordable, but when you compare the effectiveness of IV versus oral, you're comparing apples to oranges. But the oranges still may work well enough. So that's the latest story on ketamine. It's expensive, but tried and true. For more on psychedelics, watch these videos on psilocybin and MDMA. Thanks for watching. See you next time.